Real talk, slammed some nachos last week and got buku heartburn. Had to take some Zantac. Now the FDA is saying that stuff causes cancer. What the? Whoa, slow down, Tiger. Do Zantac and blood pressure medicines actually put you at risk for cancer? I'm gonna break it all down for you. Hey guys, I'm Dr. Bradley Fossier and I started Postscript because I was tired of my patients going online and getting bad information about their healthcare. So you're absolutely right. On September 13th, 2019, the FDA released a statement about the common heartburn medicine, ranitidine, also known as Zantac, saying it might contain low levels of a known cancer-causing substance. It said it was gonna look into it more to stay tuned. The medicine wasn't recalled yet, but there was gonna be more to come. This news about Zantac might sound familiar to you because over the last 2 years, some common blood pressure medicines, namely Losartan and Valisure, have been recalled, certain batches or lots of them, because they were found to have the same cancer-causing substance. So why are we all of a sudden finding this stuff in medicine? There's actually a really interesting story behind it. Do you need to switch medicines? Are you at risk? What do you need to know? Hang tight, I'm gonna answer all those questions. But first, allow me a quick digression. I promise it'll get around to a point. Because this story actually starts when a dude in Illinois named Adam Clark Joseph started noticing his daily medication wasn't quite right. He felt like the medicine he takes every day wasn't as potent as it usually was, and he started getting symptomatic to the point where he actually had to be hospitalized because his symptoms got so bad. Now, after they stabilized him in the hospital, he got out and he was like, what the heck? Why is this medicine I've been taking for so long all of a sudden not working? So he took the bottle that he had at home and he started testing it in his basement with armchair chemistry, and he actually found that the dose contained in the tablet was a lot lower than it was supposed to be. So he thought this might have something to do with the batch of medicine that he got. So instead of rolling over, Adam decided he was gonna start an online pharmacy called Valisure. And Valisure was going to test every batch of medicine that went out to its consumers to make sure it was quality medicine, contained the right dose, etc. So let's pause here for a little bit of background on how medicine is made. Medicine's a lot like cookies, it's made in batches. And just like cookies, each batch can have little differences. Now in medicines, these batches are actually called lots, and the manufacturer tracks those lots, so if there's an issue with a certain batch of medication, they can go find it and recall it. But check for yourself, you can actually find the lot number on any medicine you have. It's usually next to the expiration date. So go and find a medicine next to you and look for the lot number. So back to our story. In 2018, the FDA released a statement saying it was making some recalls on common ARB blood pressure medicines. Like I said, Losartan, Valisure, Herbosartan were the three big name ones that were getting recalled because they were found to have dangerous levels of a known cancer-causing substance. This substance is called NDMA, not MDMA, which is ecstasy, but NDMA. So the FDA actually recalled certain batches of the medicine that were found to have high levels of that substance. Well, because this recall was happening, Valisure went and said, hey, we need to test for this substance and other medicines that we send out. Well, guess what? Now that Valisure has been fishing for this chemical for a while, it's finally caught something. Valisure found this NDMA chemical in some of the Zantac it was sending out, so started testing it, got some more data, and then petitioned the FDA to recall Zantac. So this brings us back to right now, where the FDA is saying, yeah, there's an issue here, we're gonna look more into it, but hold tight, it's not quite recalled yet. Digesting this story, there's a couple of things we need to break down. Number one, what is this NDMA stuff that's being found in our medicine? Number two, how much of a cancer risk is it? Number three, what is a voluntary recall? Because that sounds kind of optional. And number four, what do I do if I'm on Zantac or one of the recalled blood pressure medicines with this chemical in it? So first, what is this NDMA stuff? Well, it's actually just one of about six chemicals that go by different acronyms that is in an umbrella category of chemicals called nitrosamines. But get ready for this, nitrosamines actually aren't new, they're actually all over the place. Nitrosamines get made when chemicals like nitrate go into your body and get converted into the more dangerous nitrosamines. Hashtag science. Nitrates, which turn into these nitrosamines, are in stuff we already know is bad for us, like cigarette smoke, stuff we don't want to think is bad for us, like bourbon and beer, but it's also in stuff that all of us consume. Nitrates are commonly used to preserve cured meats, ham, bacon, but not only that, because I know there's like vegans out there, they're like, whew, I'm safe. Nitrates are also found in drinking water and vegetables. Vegetables because nitrogen-containing substances are in the soil, nitrates are in fertilizer, and they get incorporated in the vegetables we consume. But who cares if I eat a little nitrosamine? Well, the next thing you should know is that there's about 40 years of studies showing that nitrosamines can make you prone to get cancer. Basically, when nitrosamine hits the DNA in your cells, it kind of sticks to it, it makes it funky looking, and then when that DNA goes to replicate, it kind of messes up, it can make the cells reproduce out of control, and cells reproduce out of control, that's called cancer. Based on all those studies, the FDA has figured out that about 96 nanograms of this NDMA stuff is the daily dose that puts you at risk for cancer. So it uses that as kind of a standard to say, medicine shouldn't have over 96 nanograms of this stuff in it. So now we get to the medicines. Is there enough of this nitrosamine stuff contained in these medicines to put you at risk for cancer? And what do you do if you're taking these medicines? First, the recall blood pressure medicines. And a reminder, it's all the ones ending in sartan, like Losartan and Valisure. But remember, it's just certain batches are lots of these medicines. It's not the medicine itself, it's just certain groups of it. And yes, the recall of lots of these medicines have enough nitrosamine to put you at greater risk of cancer. But it's not as much as you might think. So the FDA gives us a worst case scenario in their report. They said, imagine if you took pills from the batch that had the highest content of nitrosamine at the highest dose for 4 years. The risk with that situation would be one additional case of cancer for every 8,000 people. And it's actually unlikely that you would ever even get enough medicine in a certain batch that would put you in that highest risk category. So don't freak out. It's a potential risk. They want to get this out of our medicines because you shouldn't be getting any cancer risk in your blood pressure tablet. So if you're on one of those medicines, go look at your bottle, look at the lot number, look it up on the FDA site, go ask your pharmacist about it, see if it's one of the recalled batches, and go talk to your doctor about getting on something different. But don't stop it until you get to your doctor and talk about it. Next, let's look at Zantac. How much nitrosamine is in the Zantac pills? Well, from what Valisure says, it's a lot. Valisure says it's not that the tablets contain any particular dose, but it's actually the chemical structure of ranitidine itself. It basically contains all the components needed to react when it gets into your body to make nitrosamines. So it's like a tablet that has gunpowder and a match all in the same tablet and then goes into your body and explodes. In particular, it seems after you take a ranitidine dose that nitrosamine levels, particularly in your urine, go way up, and they have studies to kind of back this up. So that means there's a theoretical risk that particularly bladder cancer is more likely if you're taking ranitidine over an extended period. So now the debate begins. Valisure says that the nitrosamine levels in ranitidine or Zantac is in a very risky range and thinks the FDA missed it in a sense because it wasn't testing it in the environment that it's in when it's in your body. And it's only once it's in your body that it kind of forms these dangerous compounds. On the other hand, the FDA plans on looking at it more, but at this point it says the nitrosamine found in Zantac, quote, barely exceeds amounts you might expect to find in common foods. So that's why the FDA is not calling for a recall quite yet. They don't think it's as severe as Valisure is making it out to be, but they're gonna look into it. So what do you do if you're taking Zantac? Talk to your doctor, don't just listen to me, but just switch to a different medicine. There are other medicines in the exact same family as Zantac, Pepcid or Famotidine, which is very similar to ranitidine. It basically does the same thing. Talk to your doctor, like I said, don't just listen to me, but it should be easy to switch you off that medicine and switch to something else until all of this is ironed out. The last issue I want to address is the recall process itself, because when these blood pressure medicines got recalled, you'll see it referred to in all these statements and in the news as a voluntary recall. Now, voluntary recall, when I heard it, I'm like, oh, it must not be that big a deal. Like, they mean, oh, if you want to give your medicine back, then you can. It's not that serious. It's just a voluntary basis. No, that's not quite what voluntary recall means. And I think the term is kind of misleading. What voluntary recall means is the FDA has found something dangerous about the medicine, and so it goes to the manufacturer, sits down with them, and they have some negotiation about what are we going to do about this situation. And basically, the FDA and the company come to an agreement that the manufacturer is going to voluntarily take lots or batches of that medicine off the market and recall them. And this is to give drug companies a good name in these situations, because they're obviously their good name is kind of getting dragged through the media when these recalls come out. So saying that they voluntarily recalled medicines puts them in a little bit better light in these situations. But like I said, I feel like it's misleading because it doesn't diminish the safety concerns we have about the medicines. Hit like and subscribe. Hope this helped. Thanks.